Hello everyone, we were seeing voltage divider bias in the last video. We can continue the discussion regarding with the same. So we were talking about the voltage divider bias. What is the importance of biasing? I told you the Q point, it has to fix in the particular point location. Q point means it is actually the output voltage comma output current, means the DC output voltage comma DC output current without giving any input. That DC output voltage comma DC output current, it should be fixed, it should not change. Because with respect to DC value, AC is oscillating. That is, we are getting as an amplified signal. If this is changing, then the entire oscillation of AC will be distorted somewhat like this. It should be fixed. Then, how this output voltage comma output current, these are changing. That's also I told you, output current, it may change. When output current is changing, that will result in the change of output voltage, because transistor is a current control device. Means output current that is equal to beta times of input current. So whenever input current is changes, that will reflect in the change in output current beta times. But this input current we can fix. We can fix the supply, that is VBB by RB, that is input current IB here, that we can fix. It is not exactly VBB by RB, VBB minus VB minus this V by all resistance, that is actually RB. So then actually IB. So anyway, that one we can fix if we are fixing VB here. But beta may change. Beta is the factor of each amplifier. It may change from transistor. From transistor to transistor, from the model to model, it may change. That we can understand. But in the same model, BC107, the beta is 100, but it may 101, 102, or 98, 93. Like that, it may change. There is a tolerance level. In the last video, I told you one example. For a same model vehicle, car, same model car, shift to same model, the mileage may change. For 2 year user, the mileage may differ. The same situation may happen here. So I set up one amplifier circuit for a particular transistor. Somehow that transistor may get damaged. I have to replace that transistor with a new one. That time it is small change in beta is there. That reflecting the large change in the Q point. Then what will be the situation? Imagine the case, you set up one big circuit, one compound is changed, then instead of replacing that compound, you have to replace the entire circuit. That will be difficult. So the Q point should not depend on beta, that is a transistor parameter. Second one, the output current. I told you Q point is changes when output current change. So output current should that is IC should not depend on beta. Then second one, it should not depends, but this condition we cannot satisfy nor case, that is IC equal to beta, I know that IC should not depends on beta. It will depends on beta, but the effect we can reduce by using this bias. That is the advantage. Then the second condition, IC is depends on temperature. You can understand, most of the electronic equipment, when we are operating for some duration, some time, it may get heat. Mainly in the case of amplifier, everything. Because at the collector region, the heat is dissipating. Since the large charge carriers are coming and colliding there, the heat is get dissipated at collector region. The heat will increase. When heat is increasing, that will result in the increase of minority carriers. Increase in temperature result in the increase of minority carriers. As the minority carriers increases, it will result in the increase of IC. So the relation is like this. When long duration when IC is flowing, temperature will get increased. When temperature increases, minority carrier increases. Minority carrier increases, that will lead to increase of IC. When IC is increased, again temperature increases. So it's a closed loop. IC increases, temperature increases, minority carrier increases, again IC is increased, temperature is increased. This will continue as a closed loop. This is known as thermal runaway. To avoid this one, most of the case we are keeping our electronic equipments in AC. So that also affects here. So there should be a mechanism to reduce the increasing of IC due to temperature. So how it is happens here? So first we can see in the case of beta, here already I told you this VB is giving one current IB. When this current which is flowing through transistor, we are getting amplified one IC and IE. How we can calculate this IC and IE? So in this case you can see the incoming current IB, incoming from current from the source passing through R1, it is splitting into IB and I2. This IB is small compared to this one, I2. So this IB we can calculate the voltage across this point, voltage across this point VB minus voltage across this point, this VB plus voltage across this one IERE. So voltage across this point VB across R2, that we have said as VB. The voltage across this point VB, VB minus VB. So if you are applying KVL, it will be come like this, minus VB enter voltage minus VB plus VB plus IERE, that is equal to 0. So minus VB plus IERE, that is equal to 0. If you are rearranging that equation, you will get I equal to VB minus VB by RE. VB minus VB by RE. Or you can say IERE, that is equal to voltage across the resistor VE. IERE, that is equal to voltage across the resistor VE. So the voltage across this resistor plus minus, that is VE. That is nothing but IERE. So IERE, that is equal to VB minus VB. Then IE is VB minus VB by RE. Actually it is not exactly VB minus VB by RE. It is actually VB minus VB by RE plus beta by RTH. RTH is nothing but R2 divided by R1 plus R2. But this value is very very high. So beta by RTH, that will be very very small. So like that we are reducing the effect of beta here. So when we are reducing the effect of beta, because along this equation there is beta divided by RTH, that RTH is nothing but R2 divided by R1 plus R2, this one R2 divided by R1 plus R2. When this RTH, R2 divided by R1 plus R2, if it is very very high, this effect of beta will be reduced. Like that, effect of beta on I is decreasing. Then see, I is almost equal to IC. You know, IC equal to alpha I. I is almost equal to IC. So we are fixing IC without affecting beta. So that case we have cleared. Second one, there is a change in temperature. When temperature increases, IC is increasing. IC increasing means, I already told you IC is almost equal to IE, or IE almost equal to IC. When IC increases means IE is increasing. When IE increasing, voltage across this RE is increasing. That is IE RE, nothing but VE is increasing. But we know VB, voltage across this one, it is fixed one. It is not changing. VE is increasing, VB is fixed. What is the meaning of that one? VE is increasing, VB is fixed. By naturally, this is minus VBE. VBE has to decrease. This sign is minus. So, IE increases. Sorry, IC increases. Result in IE increases. IE increases, VE increases. When VE is increases, VB has to decrease. VB decrease means, its meaning is, the forward bias of this junction is decreasing. Means IC is compelled to decrease. IC is compelled to decrease. So by temperature in any situation IC increase, that will leads to decreasing VB, that is result into decreasing IC. So there is a self mechanism. So we are fixing the Q point, that IC in fixed location. Then due to this self mechanism, we are calling this is as a self bias. We are using voltage divider rule, it is known as voltage divider bias. We are using self controlling mechanism, it is known as self bias. Then what about VC? VC equal to VCC minus ICRC, that is VC actually voltage across these two points, ground and here, voltage across these two points. That VC is actually VCC minus ICRC. So again, VCC is fixed one, RC is fixed one. We fixed IC by using this mechanism. So automatically VC also fixed. So VC and IC is fixed. What are the condition of B, beta, and what are the condition of temperature? So since we are using voltage divider concept, it is voltage divider bias. There is a self mechanism to control this one, it is known as self bias. Without whatever the transistor, it is independent of transistor parameters, it is known as universal bias. All these names coming like that. Then, so you understand what is important of RE also. To stabilize this transistor or this bias, we are using RE, giving a negative feedback to this DC signal. Negative feedback, that is minus VB. When VE increase, we have to decrease VB. It is a negative feedback. We are decreasing the VB with the help of IERE or VE. So, I think we discussed almost all concept. What is VC, VE, IE, all these things. In this case, an RE is employed in the stabilization. Next one, we have to see RC coupled amplifier. That we can see in the next video. Thank you all.